Hi, I'm Dr. Donovan, and in this video, we're going to take a detailed look at celiac disease, a condition that affects the gut, but can also impact many other parts of the body. We're going to explore what causes it, the range of symptoms it can produce, how it's diagnosed and treated, as well as the long-term outlook. And as always, this video is for educational purposes only. If you've got concerns about your own health, please do speak to your own healthcare provider. So let's begin with discussing what celiac disease is. Well, celiac disease is an autoimmune condition. This means the body's immune system, which normally fights off infections, starts attacking your own tissues. In celiac disease, this immune response is triggered by gluten, a protein found in wheat, barley, and rye. When someone with celiac disease eats gluten, their immune system mistakenly identifies part of the gluten protein called gliadin as a threat and attacks it. In doing so, it damages the lining of the small intestine, particularly the villi, which are small, finger-like projections in the gut that help to absorb nutrients. Now, this damage leads to malabsorption, meaning that the body struggles to take in essential nutrients from food. Now, gluten is found in many everyday foods, including bread, pasta, and pizza, as well as breakfast cereals and cakes. It's also found in biscuits, crackers, pastries, certain gravies, sauces, and ready meals, and even most beers, which are made from barley. Even trace amounts of gluten can trigger inflammation in people with celiac disease, so it's really important that it is totally avoided, which means potentially using different cooking utensils and storing food in different cupboards to those containing gluten. So now we know what celiac disease is, well, who is affected? Well, celiac disease actually affects at least 1 in every 100 people in the UK, although the real number might actually be higher because many cases actually go undiagnosed or they're mistaken for conditions like irritable bowel syndrome, which you might know as IBS. It can develop at any age in both children and adults, and it's more common in women and people with a family history of the condition. If a parent or sibling has got celiac disease, your risk increases significantly. People are also at greater risk who've got autoimmune or genetic conditions like type 1 diabetes, autoimmune thyroid disease, Down syndrome, or Turner syndrome. So what are potential signs and symptoms? Well, symptoms can vary widely, and they might be gut-related or more general. So digestive symptoms can include diarrhea, which might be pale, greasy, or foul-smelling, bloating and flatulence, stomach cramps or discomfort, indigestion or constipation, or even vomiting, especially in children. Other non-digestive symptoms include fatigue, often due to iron or vitamin deficiencies, unexplained weight loss, anemia from iron, folate, or vitamin B12 deficiency, tingling or numbness in the hands and feet, medically known as peripheral neuropathy, difficulty conceiving or menstrual irregularities, as well as dermatitis herptiformis. This is an itchy rash with blisters, often on the elbows, knees, or buttocks, and it looks like this. Some people even have problems with coordination or balance. Now, in children, symptoms might include poor growth or delayed puberty, irritability or failure to thrive, late teething, as well as weakened bones or fractures due to poor calcium absorption. Now, it is important to note some people may have no noticeable symptoms, but are still at risk of complications if the condition is not treated. So how is celiac disease diagnosed? Well, diagnosis begins with a blood test that looks for antibodies, typically raised in celiac disease. These include tissue transglutaminase, TTG, as well as endomysial antibodies, EMA. Now, it's essential that you continue eating gluten regularly before the test, otherwise the results might be inaccurate. If the blood test is positive, you'll be referred to a gastroenterologist for an endoscopy with biopsy. This involves passing a thin tube with a camera into your small intestine to take tissue samples. The specialist will look for damage to the villi, and other follow-up tests might be arranged. These can include nutrient blood tests to look for things like iron, folate, or B12 deficiencies, a DEXA scan to check for osteoporosis in the bones, or a skin biopsy if dermatitis herptiformis is suspected. So in terms of what causes celiac disease, well, celiac disease results from a combination of both genetic as well as environmental factors. Some people carry versions of a particular gene that can cause celiac disease, but only some of these go on to develop the disease. Environmental factors can include gastrointestinal infections in early childhood, introducing gluten to a baby's diet before 6 months of age, and not being breastfed during gluten introduction, but this is still debated. We still don't fully understand why some people have got mild symptoms and others develop severe complications. Finally, how is celiac disease treated? Well, currently there is no cure. The only effective treatment is a strict lifelong gluten-free diet. So this means avoiding all sources of wheat, barley, rye, and any derivatives, so things like farina, semolina, bulgur, couscous, spelt, and durum. Most breads and pastas, pastries, and baked goods need to be avoided, beer unless it's labelled gluten-free, as well as many processed foods with hidden gluten, so for example, malt extract or modified food starch. Your doctor will also likely refer you to a dietitian who can help you build a nutritious gluten-free diet. Now, safe foods include fresh fruits and vegetables, unprocessed meat and fish, dairy products, rice, potatoes, corn, quinoa, buckwheat, and certified gluten-free oats. Now, cross-contamination is a concern. Even small traces of gluten from shared utensils or toasters can trigger symptoms, so it's important to pay attention to this. Now, in certain cases, you might also need vitamin and mineral supplements to correct deficiencies, vaccinations if celiac disease has affected your spleen function, as well as dapsone to treat dermatitis herpetiformis whilst the diet takes effect. A small number of people have got what we call refractory celiac disease, where symptoms persist despite a strict gluten-free diet. And this might require immunosuppressant or steroid treatment under specialist care. Finally, let's just look at some of the potential complications, because without treatment, celiac disease can lead to serious problems. Firstly is malabsorption of nutrients, leading to anemia and fatigue. You might also develop osteoporosis, an increased fracture risk, lactose intolerance due to gut damage, malnutrition, especially in children, or even infertility or pregnancy complications. There's also an increased risk of certain cancers, like bowel lymphoma or small bowel cancer, though the risk actually returns to normal once a gluten-free diet is followed. Finally, what are some practical tips for living with celiac disease? Well, I know firsthand, adapting to a gluten-free lifestyle can be pretty daunting, especially early on. Mistakes happen, and it takes time to learn how to shop, cook, and eat out safely. So here are a few practical tips. Firstly, always check food labels for hidden gluten. You can also join a support group such as Celiac UK for advice and community support. I put a link to this in the description box of the video. You should always ask restaurants about cross-contamination and let your friends and family know about your dietary needs. Finally, your GP or family doctor will typically arrange annual follow-ups to check for any symptoms, nutrition, as well as things like your bone health. So in summary, celiac disease is a lifelong autoimmune condition, but it can be well managed with a gluten-free diet. While the adjustment can be challenging, many people go on to live healthy, symptom-free lives. If you suspect celiac disease, or you've got unexplained symptoms like fatigue, anemia, gut discomfort, or a change in bowel habits, please do speak to your doctor and ask about testing. For more information, check out the description box of this video. Until next time, thanks for watching, and bye.